his chomesh.
It's not his chomesh. It's not his designation. Oy Dilma, or do we say, Im Tim Tulaimer Ein Adam Miskap B'Shvach Hekdesh, why should a person not use the increase that comes from Hekdesh itself? B'Shem D'Lay Afreshet, because you never designated it, it wasn't your own designation. It just, you designated something much less. This started to improve, that was on its own. Aval Hadein Kenes Chemshin, but these fifths, the Afreshet, you were the one that consecrated them. Or you could say that you can use them for the sacrifice, the boilu, because we had a question. Are you allowed to use shvach hektish, what improves in the possession of hektish for the sacrifice? Toshima, come and listen. If someone, this sounds like our Mishnah, right? If someone separates two coins for an asham, and he buys two rams l'Hashem. If one of them is worth two selah, then he could bring that one. And the second one he lets to get a mum. He sells. And then it goes to the donation fund in the temple when if the altar is empty, so they use those sacrifices. My love, is the case not the zavan ba'arba. Supposed to be Barba Zuzi. He buys for four zuz, which is one sella. The Haino sella adds in on the side. Ayel, a ram, which is half the price that it's supposed to be. Bishvach, bishavach, and it increased. The shavitamnaya, and now it's worth eight. Shema mina the meskapa bishvach hektish. We see clearly from our Mishnah that a person can use the improvements of hektish. Because who made it worth the right price? Not him. It was the animal grew. The Gemara says, one second, it's not necessarily the case. Loi, hachmayaskin and the oizel roya gabei. We're talking about that the seller just gave him a discount and gave him half price, but really its value was two coins and that's good enough. Toshima, come and listen. Lokachayel besela. Someone buys a ram for a selah, which is only half of what he's supposed to spend on his asham. Upitmai, but he fattens it up.
I'm sorry. Whatever happened to like marketplaces,
this
price and fluctuation? I mean, why can't it be totally independent? Just all of a sudden the price went up because there was a drought. A lot of animals died. Now the price is more valuable.
Yeah, that's what's
totally
going to
happen. Totally independent from
every circus. There's an Esrog going on somewhere.
No, this is what it means.
Essentially.
That this is what it means, that the value of it is the value.
Was independent of
anything. Yeah. So that's what we're saying here, that the shepherd gave him a good price, and so therefore but it still has the value of two coins. So that's satisfactory. Let's say he buys one for a seller, but that's only half the price. Upitmai, he fattens it up, midu al shtayim, and now it's worth two, so it's kosher. You see, a person can use. You see, this was a sacrifice. It grew, and he is getting benefit from its own growth. Where did it grow? On hektish property. So he's allowed to use hektish property for his own sacrifice because we said 1 second. That's not so. Lai pit me shiny. He was the one that stuffed it up. He used his own feed to make it grow, so it's not considered like it's an improvement of hektish. It's his own feed that improved the hektish. The chasalei tamaya, because on the feed he had to spend eight. Right? It doesn't come from nowhere. It doesn't come from it. Doesn't come from nowhere. Tashima, lakachayel besela. He buys a riam for a sela, vareyu b'shtayim, and now it's two. It's kasher. See, that's good enough. See, a person can use hektish. Where it says hachanami b'shepitmei. We're talking about where he fattened it up. On second, hachi hayna reisha. So why do you just say two cases? If it's the same brisa, they know it's the same brisa. I didn't know that. I mean, just from reading this. It's a Tesefta Perigdala they quoted from. Yahi Hainu Resha. It's then you have it's redundant, two cases. It says Resha the Zavan Barba Vash Bache Barba Achrina, the Chasale Tamnaya. The Resha was where he bought it for four, and it increases another four coins, which is four coins means a sella. So now it's two sella. So he's missing eight coins. He lost eight coins over this, which means that that's its value. But Sefer Dezavan Ayal Barba. He bought it for four. He had to spend three. Veshavi tamnaya, but those three increased it to a total of, it was a good investment. And now it's worth eight. So yachi ema seifa, if that's the case, so it's a chiddush here. Even though he only put in a total of seven, his sacrifice needs to be a value of eight. And it is eight, but he got to the eight based on the seven that he put into it. He got to the eight based on that. It's still going to be acceptable. A seifa yishalim sela. The seifa says that he has to pay a sela. Hachasale zayin. Mai. But if it's, oh, if he only, in the seifa, we have a case where if it doesn't improve. So he has to add an extra sela. I don't have the case of the seifa. What's the case of the seifa? There's the Sefer of our Mishnah.
Of the Raisha.
So, Hachasale Zion, but let's say he only lost seven coins and he's supposed to be eight. Mai, Yishalim Tashlam de Sela. He should have to pay the remnant, which is one more coin. And if a person is not allowed to get atonement from what increases from Hektish, what is the difference if he pays an extra coin? He needs to have the ram needs to have that value. Seven plus putting another coin on its back is not going to give you the price of the animal. So lucky you don't have the animal needs to cost that price. So really, a person can get atonement from the improvement of Hekdesh. Yehachi tashlam de sela layitin. So why does he have to give that sela? Haino taima de kayov tashlam de sela. Why does he give the extra sela? Because people will say that you can bring a ayel that's worth less than two slime. My havi Allah, what's our answer? We asked if you can use we asked if you can use Shvach Hekdesh for a sacrifice. So Toshima, come and listen. Vishasa Frasha, Yafisela. If at the time he separates the money to buy it, it's worth one sela. Vishas Kapar Yafishte Slime. At the time of the atonement, it's worth two coins. Yatza.
Lo Yatza.
You have Lo Yatza or you have Yatza?
Lo Yatza.
No interesting. It's two versions here. Yeah. Okay. This is where things get complicated. What is the? How do they translate it? How does the commentary translate it?
It says, "Lo Yatzeh." According to this version of the text, which is the version of Rabbeinu Gershom Meir Golah. The conclusion of the Gemara is that a person cannot achieve Yitovan with an enhancement of the consecrated Rabbi. By contrast, Rashi and Rambam, the text here is one fulfills his obligation.
Right. You follow?
Two different versions.
You follow? Rashi and the Rambam don't say Loi, they say Yatza. And Rabbeinu Gershon says Loi Yatza. Okay, Boy Rabbi Lazar. Rabbi Lazar has a question. Now, Rabbi Lazar is this student of Rabbi Yochanan. He's right over there, Rabbi Lozer ben Pedas, and he actually becomes Rabbi Yechanan's Chavrusa a little bit. Rabbi Yechanan isn't satisfied with him as a Chavrusa. Rabbi Yechanan actually dies because he needed a Chavrusa. He was.
But they wanted the brother in law of Resh Lakish.
Right. Resh Lakish was his brother in law who had passed away earlier. Rabbi Lozer's replacing him. So that's going to be relevant in a moment. Boy, Rabbi Lozer. Rabbi Lozer says, Adam is Kap Vishrach Hekta Shaloi. He has, Rabbi Lazar has a question. Can a person use Shvach Hekdesh the improvement of the animal after it's been consecrated to be brought as a value of 2 coins, which is the price that an asher needs to be. Rabbi Yechanan comments. It says, Kama shanim gadol zebineinu. How many years this fellow grew up with us? And he never heard this halacha from me. Rabbi Yechanan saying, like, where were you in class? Michlal, this implies, Dam Rabbi Yechanan, that Rabbi Yechanan says, in. Is that how you read it? In? Dam Rabbi Yechanan, ain. They say ain't, but it means yes. That he did have such a ruling, and he said it on which halacha? The Tanan, that it was said in the following Mishnah. Vlad Taido Tumarasa, the child of a Taida. A Taida is an animal that comes along with bread, a sacrifice, a Thanksgiving sacrifice. It's not a turkey. It's Tumarasa, and it's exchange, it's tmura that we know about. V'chein ha-mafresh teidasei ve'avda. Also someone separates a teid and he loses it. V'hipshacheres tachtein, he consecrates another one. So ein tuna lechem. They don't need bread. V'shalach Rab Chanina m'shmeid Rab Yechanan. Rab Chanina sent. How could it be Rab Chanina in the name of Rab Yechanan? There must be someone else, yeah? Rab Chanina was older than Rab Yechanan. Rab Chananya. All right. Rav Chananya sends in the name of Rabbi Yechanan. So Beis V'Shalach, correct? That Leishanu, this was only taught El Lacha Kapara, only after the first sacrifice was brought. The Vlad Ein Ton Lacham, that the offspring doesn't need bread, the 40 loaves of bread that come along with the sacrifice. Avalafnei Kapara, but before the Kapara, Ton Lacham, then you do need to bring the bread along with the sacrifice. With the extra sacrifices, Alma, Kasav Miskapa B'Shvach Ekdesh. How could you bring bread along with it? That means that you're considering the offspring your original sacrifice. That's why you're bringing the bread. Now that means that you're using a Shvach Ekdesh, an improvement of Ekdesh, for your own sacrifice. The offspring is the improvement. Where did this improvement come from? It came from Ekdesh, and you're allowed to use it. So that's a proof that Rabbi Yochanan holds you're allowed to use Shvach Ekdesh. Boy, Rabbi Loza, there's 4 questions in total. We did the first one. Rabbi Loza has a question, another question. While the animal's alive, if it becomes invalid from a sacrifice, but then it comes back to being valid as a sacrifice, do we say that it can't come back? Rabbi Yochanan says, he comments, how many years this fellow was here growing up with us and he never heard this halacha from me? Michlal de Rabbi Yechanan Amra. It sounds like Rabbi Yechanan actually taught this. It says in. Yes. Dam Rabbi Yechanan taught Behemishal Shnei Shotvim, animal that belongs to partners, Hikdish Chetzya. If one of them consecrates his half, he's a partner, he consecrates half the animal. Now, half the animal cannot be brought as a sacrifice. So v'chazer v'laka chetzi, and then he goes and he buys the other half from his partner, v'ektisha, and he consecrates the other half. It says it's consecrated, k'dusha v'ena kreva, but he can't bring it. Why? Because it's already become invalid as a sacrifice when it was consecrated halfway. So v'aisa t'mura, and that does do t'mura, t'murasa k'etzibah, and the t'mura also you can't bring, because it has the same condition as the starting one, which was that invalid sacrifice. Shmamina Tlas. Here we have also another version, so you're going to miss out on the different yourself. You have a chance to correct me now. No. Shmamina Tlas. You have 3 halachas that you get out of this. Shmamina Balechaim Nidachim. First one is the obvious one. Balechaim Nidachim. Okay, now it gets confusing because what are they adding in? Diktani ain't a craver. Okay. Ushmamina, Kedushas Damim Madcha. That only its value also pushes away. Ushmamina, Yeshdicha B'damim. Now, those seem to be repetitive. Rashi's gear says slightly different here. Ushmamina Tlas, if you notice on the side. Shema mina tlas achi garsinan. Shema mina balechem yedachim. Shema mina dichem yikarai. Habi dichem. Shema mina yesh dichem bedamen. Dichem yikarai means even before it's fully sacrificed, fully consecrated, you can already have dichem. You can already reach it, become invalid. And also, even dichem damim, even if it's only consecrated in its value, that also could push it away from being a good sacrifice. Question number three. Boy Rabbi Lazar, who's lutam ba'olam? Let's say the price of sheep goes down in the entire world, and there's no sheep that costs 2 coins. What is he going to do? Do we say you need the best sacrifices? And we have the best, right? You just don't have the 2 coins. Oy dilma, kesef shkolam binor, needs to need actually be 2 silver coins. But lucky that you don't have. Rabbi Yochanan, Rabbi Yochanan says, Kamashanam gadalnu, the base medrash. How many years we were in the base medrash, and we didn't hear this halacha. Now he's not saying this fellow didn't hear, but we never heard it. Where it says, V'loi, Rabbi Yechina never heard it. From Rabbi Yechina, Rabbi Shemeich, Rabbi Yechina said this halacha. And Nevi Shemeich, Pneimalayin, Ter Kitzra, Kitzra, B'muchasri Kapara. How come the Torah doesn't give us the price of the sacrifices for people that need to bring a sacrifice in order to eat from the temple? Shemeyuzlu Tlarm. Maybe the price will go down. And they'll never be able to eat because we'll never find an animal that costs that price. So maybe what the pshat is, we never taught this halacha in the base medrash. Probably a correction there. But Rav Zeira reviewed this every 30 days. What it means is no one asked this question in the base medrash. Gufa. Start before. Amar Rabbi Yechim Mishum Rashbi. Rechim Tan the name of Rav Shimba Yechai. Name of Leinet Nekitzvah Mechusi Kapara. Why is there no designated amount that the sacrifice needs to be for someone that needs to bring a sacrifice in order to eat from other sacrifices? Shem Yuzlut Zulayim. Maybe the price of sheep will go down. Mein Lam Takana Lechol Bekotchim, and they'll never be able to eat from sacrifices. Maskfla Abaya, Abaya has a question, Alamiyata, if that's the case. Chatas Chelev, Inasim LaKitzva, let it give a price for Chatas, which it doesn't. Del Chapar Asya, Leilashtri Bachilas Kachimu. You see, we are assuming that the sacrifices that we're really concerned about that need to have a price, that should not have a price attached to it, are ones that will allow a person to eat from sacrifices later. And that's our only concern. And why don't we put a price on it? Because if the market value goes down, these people will never be able to eat eternally from sacrifices because they'll never be able to bring their atonement. But a chatas, which is not brought because of a person could eat, it's brought for its own kapara. So what's the big deal? Put a price on it. So maskifla. Rava asks him, Elamiyata Hashem Nazir, Davali Kitzva. What about Hashem Nazir? It does have a price. The Levatolahu Dasi. Because it's coming to stop his Naziris. It's supposed to stop his Naziris to start it again, right? It comes for naught. Doesn't permit anything. So. And there's nothing that comes for no purpose other than this Asham Nazir, because it doesn't allow him to eat. All it does is allow him to start over his new counting. So Kasha, these are questions why we don't have a price on that. We'll still leave it over here. What are we going to do for tomorrow? We have to finish this page. Let's try to start. Yeah, let's. I'll try to come at 5:20. I'll see. I don't know if I'll be able to, but we'll try. I'll aim for that.
I'm not going to turn 5 o'clock in the morning.
Abi talks very fast.
As long as you don't carry, I'll come back on your door.
We have a scene tomorrow.
Are we starting tomorrow?
Mm-hmm. We'll try to start tomorrow at 5:20.
The shul is sponsoring.
Okay, so that's 2:20 a.m. Oh, okay.
Oh boy. Well, compared to 2:30, it's not the big deal.